Namaste YouTube, welcome to CAFE ENOMA and welcome to our reaction to Steve Hackett. And the song that we are going to react to is Behind the Smoke.
This is a Patreon request by our patron Jeffrey.
Yeah.
And we are going to get ready for a really big song perhaps. Because the time limit, whenever it's so long a song, 7 minutes plus, it either is going to be something amazing musically,
yeah,
or lyrically, or it's going to be exactly the opposite.
It should be scintillating.
Either way, it's going to be a completely real, raw, pure, spontaneous, impromptu, genuine, authentic and honest reaction by Kirti and me. You can check out our Patreon page to learn more about us. Having said that, it's time to begin. Steve Hackett of Genesis fame, right?
Yeah.
Behind the Smoke. We've heard a lot of Genesis and a lot of songs of the members of Genesis.
Yeah, almost every member.
Which is your biggest hit before we start? Anything that you remember out of all these guys?
You're
instantly,
not,
right now, can you name
you
one
no
song that
mine.
Stands out? No Son of Mine? Okay.
Yeah, I like that.
For me, it's In the Air Tonight, Phil Collins.
In the Air Tonight,
and
yeah,
Another Day in
nice.
Paradise.
Yeah.
Two songs
another
of
day
Phil
in
Collins.
Paradise. Wow.
Two songs instantly come to mind. I don't remember a single song of Genesis that I would like to mention here. Mm-hmm. I definitely may remember some of the songs,
yeah,
titles, but I don't remember it musically.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that's something that I would like to hear. But
yeah,
Another Day in Paradise and In the Air Tonight,
great,
both these songs I love.
Yeah.
Drumming, one for the drumming, In the Air Tonight,
mm-hmm,
and the vocals, the arrangement, and Another Day in Paradise for phenomenal lyrics and a good tune. Let's get started, Steve Hackett. I don't know if this will be in that league. If it is, we are in for a wonderful 7 minutes or so.
7 minutes of a life.
Behind the smoke is black. There is no turning back. Our souls are burning on the stone. There's no time to weep. We've come this way so far from home. And though the wounds are deep, is out of reach. We meet our future all too soon. A knife into our hearts, a world that's torn apart, a blood red hunter's we'll be right back.
Egyptian, Moroccan.
Couldn't help but think about Deep Purple and Led Zeppelin. I think they played a huge role in this inspiring Steve Hackett. It was nothing like Genesis, but almost totally like a particular song of Deep Purple. Though I'm not very sure of that song, but I know how it goes. I think it's Sweet Child in Time, but I'm not sure. And Led Zeppelin's Kashmir. So it definitely has some influence. Either they have been influenced by this song, depending when this was released, or this song has been influenced by that. Either way, it was absolutely brilliant. Like Kirti said during the song, it had a nice, strong Egyptian and Moroccan vibe. What are your thoughts on it all?
For me, I haven't heard much of Led Zeppelin as well as Deep Purple, both of them.
Just one song of Led Zeppelin actually, Kashmir, the one of the biggest songs.
Alright, we keep getting requests for that.
And Deep Purple
also
just one
song. Allowed, what I did gather from the song was, just like I said, it was more Moroccan and Egyptian. It sounded like Steve Hackett's collaboration with Sufi music. I haven't heard much Sufi music apart from when they use it in Bollywood. You know, they keep, because there are a lot of musicians from India who join the Sufism and the music and everything, because one of the major styles of music in India even today, and there are gharanas even of Sufi music. There are states that where it is very, very popular, like Rajasthan, and in the south as well. So for me, it felt like it was his collaboration with Sufi music, with the instruments, and he didn't try to overshadow with his guitaring, but he let everyone shine through, whether it was the drumming or the percussion that was over here, whether it was the mandolin like instrument or the entire sound altogether. I liked how it built up initially and his deep voice singing, and for me it was more about the music and the experience than about the lyrics. The lyrics were very limited and very little, and not giving out too much description or information behind the smoke. It felt like some it's a troops or somebody's group's expedition or adventure or some journey. That's what it felt like, but it was more of a musical journey to listen to.
Definitely was, and this is a memorable song. Definitely I'll remember this. I'd like to hear it a few times. This is one of those songs which definitely I would like to add on my playlist at least for a week or two. It's worth adding it on. And this is one of those few songs after a very long time, either Genesis or a member of Genesis,
yeah,
one of the few songs after ages that I would like to add, right, or I will add to my playlist tonight.
Yeah.
So it's been very rare, mm-hmm, unfortunately. We had a good run at the beginning,
mm-hmm,
but then there was a lot of
songs which
were totally mediocre, at least to me,
mm-hmm,
and nothing memorable at all. In fact, I don't even remember the song names.
Many songs, yeah.
It's that bad with them.
Yeah.
This is refreshing after ages. A good song, musically very strong and diverse influences. It is something to savor. It will connect with different regions and cultures, mainly because of that diversity. Like Kirti was talking about Sufi music.
Mm-hmm.
Similarly, the people in Africa will definitely cover with it, especially North Africa.
Mm-hmm.
They will connect with this kind of music instantly.
Mm-hmm.
Incidentally, Kashmir as well.
Yeah.
The song Kashmir, which is Led Zeppelin's most popular song,
mm-hmm,
the band members themselves have agreed,
mm-hmm,
when they were asked in an interview ages ago.
Mm-hmm.
So the fact is that their most popular song is not about Kashmir in, mm-hmm, India,
mm-hmm,
or Pakistan.
Mm-hmm.
It's about a place in Morocco. So unfortunately that town had some weird sounding name,
right,
and it wasn't that popular in the world.
So
these guys just thought of Kashmir from somewhere. Possibly they just took a bunch of city names or town names or some region names which were popular for tourism.
Kashmir is very
And at that time in the 70s, when the song probably came out, 70s, 80s, Kashmir was one of the most beautiful and most popular places.
Yeah.
Not just in India, but whole of Asia.
Right.
Today it's a different story. It is really beautiful.
Due to late 80s terrorism,
so much politics in that area.
Unfortunately,
it hasn't been the same.
Yeah.
But yeah, strong influence of Kashmir, essentially of Led Zepp, and Deep Purple song, I'm not sure. But you guys probably know what I'm talking about after hearing this. You may know what I'm talking about. Something like that. Oh, that's wonderful. That's a great song. And I actually heard them performing that live once in Mumbai. I went to their concert twice in Mumbai, but once they performed the song. I think it's Recharged in Time, but I'm not sure. Not very sure. Big song of theirs, but I don't know, somehow I'm confused now. Anyway, that's it for this one. Goodbye.